Okay, hi. The invisibility cloak is real, and all of my Slytherin dreams have just come true. Hello and welcome back to IO. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today we're talking about the legit ability to become invisible. I just told you that I'm a Slytherin, but do you know what Hogwarts house Charlotte Dobre, the Potato Queen, is in? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Also, if you know your Hogwarts house, tell me in the comments, and also leave this video with a good thumbs up, because invisibility. Also, if you guys want to connect with me on social media, the link to my Instagram is in the description box. Go. All right, spectral cloak me. So visibility and invisibility pretty much comes down to light and refraction, basically light tricks. Scientists have long suspected they could manipulate light in order to disguise something like Hazard's cloak. You know, when he's sneaking around Hogwarts after hours and causing all kinds of mayhem. When you see things, what you're really seeing is the way light interacts with those objects. The thought process behind the cloak is that developers could make 3D objects invisible from all directions by selectively transferring energy between certain colors of the light wave. So basically, by changing the way the light interacts with this object. Stay with me. After the wave has passed through the object, the device used in the spectral cloak would then restore light to its original state, thereby making the cloak invisible. Again, still with me? Luis Romero Cortez, a member of the Optical Society, said, "Conventional cloaking solutions rely on altering the propagation path of the illumination around the object to be concealed." Now, he continued by saying that their solution is better because it would allow the light waves to pass through the cloak rather than bending around it, which wouldn't create a full visibility effect, just a distortion effect. It is complicated, but this is how it works. For example, if the object reflected a green light, the light in the green range would be shifted to a different color, so there'd be no green light to reflect, making it seem invisible. Then, when the wave has passed through the object, the invisibility device would then reconstruct the wave, reflecting the original color. I know that it sounds complicated, but it's always worth trying to understand the science behind things. If you can get your head around it, then great, but if you can't, don't worry, because the main thing here is invisibility cloak. Yay! The team behind the invention tried out their cloak with a laser pen, and it was successful. As of yet, it seems the invention is still in its prototype phase, so we don't know when or if us muggles will ever be able to buy one or how much they would cost. Wait, did I say muggles? I strongly believe that with science, any magic is possible. So guys, would you want an invisibility cloak? What would you do with it? I think I'd use mine for sneaking backstage at cool gigs and concerts. Can you imagine? I could like hang out with Taylor Swift and she wouldn't even know. That actually does sound a bit creepy. Maybe I wouldn't do that. Also, don't forget to let me know what your Hogwarts house is. I need to know. Right, before I tell you Charlotte's and we wrap up this video, I'm just gonna read a few comments from a video I did a week ago about a Chinese satellite crashing into Earth. Oliver Holgerson said, "I've seen a falling star, and a lot of them in the same night, actually, on one date, I think. It happens around every year in about August." That's really interesting. I wonder what that is. I don't know what could possibly be happening, like a yearly meteor shower? I don't know. Lucy Murdoch said, "I may have read the title as another cheese satellite is going to crash into Earth, and oh my god, I wish that was the case, so long as no one was injured. Like, cheese raining from the sky is pretty much the literal dream. That and invisibility cloaks. Oh my god, with invisibility cloaks, I could like have as much cheese as possible, although I am against stealing. Such a conundrum. So, what Hogwarts house is Charlotte in? Well, she may or may not be a Slytherin just like me. You may have two Slytherin hosts here. I actually made a video of her doing her whole sorting on my YouTube channel, and Azzyland is there, so you should go and check it out so you can see how she answered. Do it. Do it. And also, don't forget to let me know what house you're in. Thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure you give it a good thumbs up, share it with a friend, and stay subscribed for more daily news. Bye.